Today I want to share with you some ways that I know to make some really nice looking Venn diagrams. Now this was inspired by a presentation I saw earlier this week, and I saw a Venn diagram that looked kind of like this. And I think we're pretty familiar with what a Venn diagram is. It shows, you know, three or more individual sort of concepts and how they overlap, and kind of is a way to visualize the relationships between them. So I'm just going to show you how I would make this directly in PowerPoint. It's pretty easy using just circle shapes. So I'm going to go up to the Insert tab, and then I'm going to go to Shapes and then Insert a Circle. I'm going to double click to make my circle here, but I want it to be bigger. So I'm going to take the corner, I'm going to hold down the Shift key, and I'm going to drag it. And that makes everything stay proportional, nice and proportional. So then I'm going to hit the Control D, and that will duplicate the circle. There's my circle. I'm going to move it over like a Venn diagram here. And then I'm going to do one more duplicate, Control D, to give another circle here. And I'm going to move that down here to be the bottom circle on my Venn. Now, obviously, we know the circles are overlapping, but we can't see the individual sections. So to do that, you want to play with the fill color transparency. And you can see that the format background tab is already open when you have a shape. If it wasn't, you could just click on your shape, right click, and go to format shape. And this dialog box would open up here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually select all of these circles at once. So I'm going to hold down the Shift key, and I'm going to select the other two circles. So all three are selected. And then if you go over here to the right, you'll see under the fill color tab that there's this transparency slide bar. I'm going to go ahead and adjust the transparency of the color so that you can see those overlaps. So you can see, you can actually just play with this to see. 100% transparency makes the shapes completely clear. And if we go to about 50%, let's see, I'm going to go to like maybe 40% right here. And I think that's kind of a nice fill color there. Now, you can see now that you might want to adjust the position of your Venn just a little bit to make things look a little bit more equal. I like something like that. And then I'm going to go ahead and adjust the colors that I have for it right here. I'm going to make this one that nice red color. And we'll keep that one blue. We can also adjust the lines of the line color for each of the shapes. So I want this to be a darker red. Oops, that's my fill. Adjust that line color to the darker red. This is going to be the darker teal color. And then this is going to be the darker blue. Nice. All right, and there you have sort of a basic Venn diagram that you can sort of adjust however you need to. Now, the thing that inspired this video is that when I saw the presentation, the presenter wanted to highlight the middle section of the Venn, or the overlapping center of the Venn, to see how these three concepts overlapped and see what the relationship was between them. But what they did is they drew a freeform shape over the middle to highlight that middle section overlap. And it looked really sloppy like this. I'm going to show you how they did that. I'm going to delete this shape, go up to Insert, and then go to the Shapes dropdown, and go all the way over here to the Freeform shape. When you click that, take your mouse and just click and draw all the way around so that it fills like that. You release your mouse, and then there you have a new freeform shape that you can edit just like all the other shapes. So I'm going to fill that with yellow, and maybe give it a nice dark line. So that's one strategy you might use to highlight the center, but as you can see, it looks pretty sloppy, choppy. It's not exact. It's not the exact middle sort of section. So there is a way to do this in PowerPoint where you can actually highlight that middle section and have it be exact. So I'm going to go ahead and go on to this next slide here. What you need to do is use the Merge Shapes dropdown. So what you have to do first is select your circle. And I'm going to select all the circles that I want to overlap. So all three of these I'm going to select by pushing Shift and then click with your mouse. Go up to the Shape Format tab. And then you see over here to the left, under Insert Shapes, you see this drop-down menu here that says Merge Shapes. I'm going to go ahead and click that. And then you have a few options here. Union, Combine, Fragment, Intersect, and Subtract. I'm going to go ahead and click the Fragment And what this fragment button will do once I click it, it will actually fragment the three overlapping circles so that each of the individual sections that overlaps is its own individual shape. You can see I can select each individual one, and I can actually edit it. I can edit each individual section as its own shape. Well, you can see that all the colors changed blue. They will all change based on the first object that you select in those three that we selected here. So for this, in this case, it was that first circle down here that we selected first. So all of the shapes turned that same color. So now I can just go ahead and update the colors. I'm going to keep that one into that red. And I'm going to keep this one that teal. And then for the middle, I kind of just like to choose something in between, but one of these darker fills will sort of look okay for these. Doesn't really matter which one you do, but I tend to do it on the same color palette that that was going. And then for the middle, let's just highlight this as a nice yellow. Super nice. So you can actually edit your Venn diagram to really highlight individual sections. Now, if I wanted to do this in a presentation where I was highlighting more, what I might do is first highlight, make the entire Venn diagram gray, and then I'm going to highlight the individual section that I want to talk about with a different sort of action color. So I'm going to first, I want everything here to be gray. So I'm going to go ahead and take my mouse and drag it all the way across the page over each of the shapes, and that becomes, that highlights all of the shapes. I'm going to go ahead and right click and group them so they all become basically a group shape together. So right click and then click on group. And now this makes all of those individual shapes into one shape. So I can go ahead and drag the whole thing and it'll take everything with it. I'm also going to go ahead and fill this shape with a gray color. I think that looks pretty nice. I'm going to go ahead and select no line so that all the lines kind of disappear. I could actually just do the same color of line as the circles, and that would make everything look a little bit more overlapped here. I'm going to go ahead and click on that middle section and make this into a nice highlighted center. Now, this isn't exactly what I wanted it to look like, so what I'm going to go ahead and do is look at some of those lines again. I'm going to go and make these solid white lines, and maybe increase that to 2 points, increase this line to 2 points. Now that looks just a little bit better. Now if I wanted to, in this case, I want to highlight the center relationship, and so I'm going to talk about the center relationship in my presentation. But maybe I would want to just talk about one specific overlap, and then in that case, I could fill that with a totally different color and just keep that one the solid gray. So you can see how this might work. Every single time on every single slide, I might look at a different section of the Venn, and that's how I would highlight it there. So I hope that you found something useful in this video, and please tell me in the comments how you use your next Venn diagram in the presentation that you give. Thanks.